Hello and welcome to Maths with Jacob. This lesson will focus on place value. In everyday life, we use numbers for all sorts of reasons. Some examples are as follows. We might hold up three fingers. We might have $15 in our pocket. There might be 234 students in our grade at school. There could be 1,356 students in the whole school. Let's look at the word digit and see what that means with respect to numerals or numbers. The above word is used to describe a single numeral. For example, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 are all digits. That is, each of them is a single digit. Let's look at the number 56. That contains two digits, a 6 and a 5. 432 contains three digits, a 2, a 3 and a 4. Have we ever stopped to think about how larger numbers are constructed and what values we give to the individual digits in each of the places? Let's have a look on the next slide. The meaning of different numbers. Let's look at one digit. For example, 6 apples. Now 6, as we've just seen, is a single digit. In this case, we are referring to apples. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The above diagram represents 6 single apples. That is, 6 equals 6 times 1. So that is the meaning of 6. 6 times 1. Two digits. For example, 12 marbles. Here we have two digits. One digit, two digits. That's what we mean by two digits. Let's look at the two. See that two there, which is in the first column? That means two single marbles. So that's what the two stands for, those marbles there. The one, which is in the second column, represents one lot of 10. Because it's in the tens column. The second column across is the tens column. The above diagram represents 12 marbles. That is, the number 12 means one lot of 10, because of that one, plus two lots of 1, because of that 2. 10 plus 2, and that gives us our 12 marbles. With three digits, example $347, here's the units column, the tens column, and the hundreds column. So the 7 means 7 times 1 because it's in the ones column. The 4 means 4 times 10 because it's in the tens column. And the 3 means 3 times 100 because it's in the hundreds column. With respect to four digits, let's assume we have 5,348 people. So we have an 8 in the ones column, a 4 in the tens column, a 3 in the hundreds column, and a 5 in the thousands column. So the 8 represents 8 times 1. The 4 is 4 times 10. The 3 is 3 times 100. And the 5 is 5 times 1,000. So let's take a step backwards now and look at the units and the tens column only, just to increase our understanding and make it a little bit stronger. All two-digit numbers have a units column and a tens column. For example, if we look at the number 47, there's the first column. So in the units, you have a 7. There's the second column, so in the tens column you have a 4. The 7 means 7 times 1. The 4 means 4 times 10. 7 ones are 7. 4 tens are 40. 40 plus 7 is 47. So that is the meaning of this number here. When you see it like that, that's how we break it down. Triple digits. These numbers are made up of any combination of 3 single digits. And here are some examples here. They're all triple digits. Consider the number 362. It is made up of 3 digits. 1, 2, 3. Triple digits. In the first column here, we have a 2. So in the units column, we have a 2. In the tens column, we have a 6. In the hundreds column, we have a 3. So that's really 2 times 1. The 6 is 6 times 10. The 3 is 3 times 100. So altogether, the value of the 2 is actually 2, because it's 2 units. The value of the 6 is 60, because it's in the tens column. And the value of the 3 is 300, because it's in the hundreds column. So altogether, that gives you 362. If we have the number 839, 9 in the units column, 3 in the tens column, 8 in the hundreds column. The 9 is 9 times 1, the 3 is 3 times 10, and the 8 is 8 times 100. So the values are 9, 30, and 800, which is 839. If we have 980, so there's a 0 in the units column, an 8 in the tens column, and a 9 in the hundreds column. So 0 times 1, 8 times 10, and 9 times 100. So that's 0 plus 80 plus 900, which gives you 980. So that brief explanation there tells you how to actually interpret a number like this, 839 for example, what each of these digits mean, and that really increases your understanding of our number system.